On this video, we'll show you how to install MAMP on your computer. Let's open a browser and proceed to mamp.info. We're gonna download the gray version, which is the personal version of MAMP. Hit download. It takes about 172 megabytes. Once the installation is finished, we go to our downloads folder and open the MAMP package and proceed with the installation. Just follow the instructions. Continue, continue, agree, install for all users on this computer, uninstall. Type your password. Okay, MAMP has been successfully installed. Close the window. Now we proceed to our applications folder and locate MAMP. It's not going to be the MAMP Pro folder, but the MAMP folder. Then we'll double click and open MAMP. Launch MAMP and we proceed with the setup. To set up MAMP, we have to open the preferences. We have the 5.5.3 version, which is the latest version at this moment. Then we're going to Apache, and on Apache here, document root. What we're going to do here is to select the folder where we're going to install all of the websites and work on them from the computer. So that's going to be our server. Personally, I like to have a folder called Sites on my user home folder on the computer. So we go to the user home folder, create a folder and call it Sites. When it's done, we can select from MAMP the Sites folder. That's it. MAMP has been set up. Now this is where we are going to install all of our websites. So hit OK. Open preferences again, we're not done yet, and we're going to ports. Here we have Apache port 8888 and 8889 for MySQL port. This is the default. However, to work with Joomla, the Apache port is going to be number 80 and the MySQL port is going to be 3306. Now we can start the server. Type your password. Make sure you have two green lights. Apache green light and MySQL green light. That's it. The server is installed and set up on your computer. Next step will be to install a version of Joomla. For that, we go to joomla.org, go to downloads, and let's download the version 2.5 package. There it is. So what we're going to do is drag and drop this version of Joomla to the Sites folder. Make sure it's unzipped. Then we rename this folder with the name of the website, in this case, my website. Once that is all set, we can install Joomla. This is all the installer package within our Sites folder. To install Joomla, we again open the browser and type localhost and the name of the website, my website. Enter. And we are on the installation window. We select the language, English in this case, next. We make sure that everything is green. We are okay, hit next. The license, next. Okay, in the database configuration, we are going to select as database type, MySQL. The localhost name, we'll leave it as localhost. Username, we type root, and password is going to be also root. Now, the database name, we can call it the name of the website as well, my website, and hit next. Now we're going to skip this step. This is to configure the FTP. We're going to talk about this on a later video. Select next. Now, here we type our site's name, our email, and a password. verify the password. Now we're going to install the sample data. Select Next. On this screen, we need to remove the installation folder. So we proceed and remove the installation folder. And that's it. Joomla has been successfully installed. Then we can proceed to the site. This is our website's front end. In order to access the administration aid of Joomla, Joomla has a front end and a back end. We open a new tab and type localhost / the name of our site / administrator, enter. And we are on the back end. We have the front end and the back end of Joomla. Now, if we want to access the administrator, we have to type our username, which is admin, and our password. Login, remember password, and that's it. We are in the back end of Joomla. Front end, back end.